Hi, welcome back to Bath Time with Brielle. I'm your host, Brielle, and this is my fucking bathtub. What is going on this week? It's been a little bit warmer in New York, which is amazing because I get to wear my ho outfits, my ho attire. I've been a little sad this week over all the bans happening. First it was Tumblr, and then, you know, Instagram is being hit really hard. One of my favorite magazines, File Magazine, was shut down like twice in 1 week, which really fucking sucks. And I don't know what there is we could do about it. It just feels like the content that I want to see, the content that I want to make, is prohibited, and it makes me sad. It's so important that sex educators have a platform such as Instagram to talk about really important things. In my opinion, I just think it's hurting more people than it's helping. And that is that on that. We'll go ahead and move on to the first question of this episode, which is, how do you feel about circumcision? The person who asked this clearly knows that I go around at parties talking about how I feel about circumcision, so I apologize for anyone I've trapped at a party talking about circumcision. It's just fucking crazy to me that we're cutting little baby dicks every day. It just fucks me up. So I watched the documentary American Circumcision on Netflix. Great documentary, you need to go watch it after you watch this. The documentary debunks every fact you thought you knew about circumcision, whether that's cleanliness, STI rates, UTI rates, HIV rates. Everything you knew about circumcision is false. Did you know that curved penises aren't naturally occurring in nature? That's fucking a slightly botched circumcision. The people in the documentary, they call themselves intactivists. Look it up. I think it's just super important that we watch this. I'm an intactivist and this is my cause. Go watch the documentary, learn the facts. Next question is, anal douching, how do you do it? The first piece of advice I want to give you is just maintaining a healthy diet, eating foods that are rich in fiber, you know, drinking water, making sure you have nice hard poops before you participate in any anal play. You don't want to have diarrhea before you have anal sex. So, anal douching. Sometimes the word that's used is enema, and sometimes it's douche. But essentially, I think the most popular and cheapest version is the bulb douche. It's basically like a rubber or plastic bulb, and that has the solution in it, and then it has like a little tube that's already lubed up to stick up your rectum. They also have douches that attach to the shower head that you could also insert. You want to make sure that you're not going too deep. You want to make sure that it's not too hot, too cold. You want to make sure that you're not doing it too often. There's a lot of good bacteria in the anal canal, and when you douche, that gets removed, and that can cause stomach problems, and it's just not very healthy for you. So there you go. Be a little slut. Put it in your butt. The next question is, can you describe what a vaginal orgasm feels like? It's like, you know those fireworks that burst and they come down like willow trees? It's kind of like that. It's kind of like just this big explosion and then... Or it's like a house song and it's like choo, 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 and then the break before the chorus that's like choo. A vaginal orgasm is when you think you ran out of candy, but then you look in the drawer and you have like a whole packet of Starbursts. So if you guys remember, about a week ago, I took a poll about if straight identifying males like anal play. And the numbers are in. Drum roll, please. 77% of you said, fuck yes, and 23% of you said, ew, gross. A nice subtle way to ask your partner to play with your ass is to send them an article about it. Be like, oh wow, this is crazy, look at this article about ass play, like, don't be afraid to ask. It's that time of the episode where all of my bubbles are gone. Thank you guys for joining me in my tub, it's been a pleasure, as always. Don't forget to like it, subscribe it! Love it! Share it with your friends, repost it on Instagram. And if you know anyone who got that bath salt connect, hit me up, ring my line. Okay, bye!